to so many people. I don't even know if I should introduce her. She's a mom. Let's start with that. A wife, a sister, a TV host. There you go. A writer. She's a publisher. She's a concert superstar. She's a mentor. She's a wonderful friend. And she's our very own, here we go, Tina Turner, Luisa Marshall.
Hey!
Thank you for coming to the show.
Hi. Woo. Hi. Hello, everyone.
We are so happy to finally have you.
I know. I'm so happy that I finally decided that, hey, we have to get together at least one afternoon to do this.
Oh my gosh, yes, because I know you. I am lucky if I could actually chance upon you here in BC. You're either here, there, doing a tour, or, you know, anything can happen, or doing your show, you know, or being stage mom. So many things. So I am just so glad that you had this little window of time to come, and I really appreciate it.
No, I do appreciate your invitation all the time.
Yeah. So I'm here, yes. And we're gonna rock it, we're gonna rock it. Hello, everyone.
Yes, we're starting, we're having so much fun. Okay, and I don't even know what to ask first, but let's start with your very successful Relive the Music.
Relive the Music, 50s and 60s. I love that show.
When did you even start that?
Like, we started it last year, 2019. Oh. No. We started 2019. Yes, we did. 2019. But then, you know, it was actually Steve, my husband, Steve Marshall, was actually the one who started it all. Like, he could, the concept, everything about the 50s and 60s shows that he really wanted to bring on stage. And it was actually, he told me it was 20 years in the making. Because it was... Because we've been doing the Tina show for so long that, mm-hmm. and we've been so busy with it, you know, my Tina Turner tribute show. So it's always been put in the back burner, right? So when we had that opportunity to finally do it, and he finally said, yes, I got to do this. We have to do this. And he told us about this concept then. We all helped and collaborated on the project, and wow, it's so successful.
A very different project from
it
your
is.
Tour, from your
from my Tina. Tina it's Turner. So much different. I'm telling you, it's not easy.
No, the costume changes.
Yes.
The harmonies.
Everything.
The choreography.
Everything. Because I shouldn't sound like Tina in a lot of songs, right? And I have to do the backup too, which was so hard for me.
Sorry, you're the harmony.
I know, and it's like, oh, mom, your harmony. So,
oops.
Yeah, even my sister told her, Louie, your harmony is kind of off in that. That's not the harmony.
Oh, sorry, I thought I was the lead. You know, that's because you're all in music.
Yes.
So you know.
The whole family is.
The whole family,
for all those who don't know, my husband is a drummer, producer. He also sings if we let him.
He also sings. Should hear him.
Yeah, and then our two daughters,
of course,
are also involved. Of course, Zenia and Kimi on guitars, Zenia on vocals, and my sister on vocals. We've been singing together for the longest time. So yeah, we came here to Canada together with our other sister and my brother in a band. We were called Hall of Fame Band, and this was way back 1989.
We really love the Relive the Music.
You like all the music there?
Yes.
Yeah, it was so hard, you know, it was so hard. Steve had a hard time, we had a hard time, because what happened was he just put together all the songs that he wanted to put there.
Okay.
Like all the songs that was, you know, hit. Those hit songs of the 50s, 60s, he really researched on it.
Wow.
But then we came along as we were collaborating, and we had to inject some of the songs that are still relevant up to now.
Mm-hmm.
So those are the 50s and 60s songs that we find very relevant, and a lot of artists still sing, and you can still hear it.
Yes.
You know, and yes. There are many, many artists, singers, performers who are actually making a cover out of it.
Wow. Yes.
So it's really pretty cool. I didn't think at first that I was going to like it.
Especially because you're used to it.
Because I'm a rock person, that, you know. But it was just amazing because my hair stands sometimes every time you sing those songs on stage. And the audience.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
Unprecedented. Like
it was so cool to see a lot of people enjoying the 50s and 60s music, and especially enjoying our show.
Such a beautiful show. It's like walking back in time.
Yes.
And there are songs that I remember my parents were singing, and I sang with them. You have Nat King Cole. You have a Nat King Cole song there. See?
Yes.
Oh my gosh. You just really, you're reliving the past. Like, what else can I say? And your choreography. And you have a lot of tribute artists that you feature on the show.
Yes.
It's like a whole group of.
It was actually really nice to be able to feature and highlight local talents. And it's amazing. There's so many good singers, performers around Metro Vancouver.
Yeah.
So it's really great to know that and meet these people through the show.
And it's really all about supporting one another, which is what you're doing.
Yes.
You're bringing on a lot of artists that we would probably not have been able to watch.
Exactly.
Because they don't do like concerts every now and then.
We're happy. We're happy. We have a we also change some people because some people have to have other projects. Mm. So we have like some new people in the show. So it's really nice because all these people are our friends that became our friends, and we support them in their projects and then support us in our projects. And so it's really nice. The world is so big. There's so many opportunities everywhere, talking about opportunities, it's really nice to just open your doors to people, like to people who are good people and very talented and who can actually help the show. And so because everybody was cooperating and very understanding and considerate, so we're all getting along well.
You know, of course, as you go along, I'm sure you're adding in more stuff. You're, okay, we should do this.
Yes.
You know, it's always a never-ending journey.
Yeah, the best time really, it was always after the show where we critique ourselves.
Oh,
and
yes.
Yeah, I had like numerous malfunctions, wardrobe malfunctions.
You did it so well. Nobody even knows.
It's so funny. And the same thing with Zenia. And that was same thing with Tota. Same thing with a lot of our, with Steve, and you know, sometimes there would be glitches, technical difficulties, and what are you gonna do, right? I mean, it's just.
The show must go on.
Oh yeah. So we get used to it, and we just make the show better and better each time.
Yeah, and that's where you see your professionalism, because you know, you don't get rattled, you just keep going.
We take our work and our business seriously, but you really have to learn how to laugh at yourself. Don't take for granted your audience sees every tiny little thing. So it's just, you just need to move on and just learn how to laugh at your mistakes.
That's very true. And that's a very healthy attitude because you can't dwell on these things.
Did I tell you one time I had a sold out show?
When did
Kimi
you not
and
have
Zenia. No, it was like so big, the audience. First song I came out, people were like that, and everybody was rocking. Yeah, put your hands together. And then as soon as I stepped on stage, boom, I fell.
Oh.
That was
what first happened song. To the audience? Did they stop?
They were like, nobody was breathing. And I stood up and I was like,
and then the cheers.
Like,
course,
and then right. Everybody was like, what happened to your clapping? Come on.
and then after the
full song, I was hurting. And my knee, it was bleeding. And
because you were in heels for sure. You always perform.
Yeah,
in
no,
heels.
I missed a step. Because I was going up the stairs to on the stage.
Well,
yeah, I missed a step. And I just disappeared.
And it's not like you're...
Kimi and Zenia were like,
Where's mom? Where's
right yeah, under here. I fell. Yeah, it happened.
Well, how are you? Were you able to?
I performed the whole time. It was sold out. Super. We had a standing ovation, and all I said was like, "Wow, that was such a dramatic entrance!"
Oh my gosh!
Everybody
yes.
Roaring, right?
We still have two more theater shows. Okay, please go to LuisaMarshall.com. You're gonna go crazy because we have a lot of other shows aside from the theater shows, but we just want to do this, you know, just because we want to kill time. Right?
Right.
Yeah. I just want to see if my band is still awake. Away! Oh, look at that. He's taking selfies right now. Oh, you're really on Facebook. Oh my goodness, you're live on Facebook. Hi! Come on, don't make people say hi! The whole world's watching! Hello!
You've been on Oprah twice.
Thank
You've been
you.
On Ellen mm-hmm. because you're a wonderful Tina. And is that Selena Gomez actually there?
Yes. Ellen squad, they were all the real
wow.
artists. I was the only one who was fake.
Okay, question.
I was really surprised because I didn't think that they were the real artists at first, but they were the real artists. It was just me. That's not.
Now, that's did they think that you were the real Tina?
Yes. Everybody thought I was the real Tina. The only people who didn't say, who knew that I'm Luisa, I'm not the real Tina, was Ellen and their director and my handler.
Was that planned by Ellen? Like, you are the only
It was actually
artist.
Planned by Ellen, and I was really totally surprised because when we rehearsed our spot,
yeah,
when we rehearsed that segment, it was different. The script was different. Yeah, the way they introduced me and everything is different. Yeah, I was stunned because Ellen introduced me as Tina Turner. We would never do that in any of our shows. Every time we have a voiceover or in time the band would introduce me, it's always Luisa Marshall as Tina Turner.
Yeah.
Never as Tina Turner. No, we wouldn't do that. We have so much high respects for the queen of rock and roll,
of course,
Tina Turner, and we don't do that at all. And I was just really stunned. And the worst thing was, and this was, I think, Ellen didn't expect, I had a standing ovation when I came out. That because they thought it was the real Tina Turner.
She's
so it just made
funny.
Matters worse, and I was like, and the same thing with Ellen. Ellen would be like, oh no, oh, you can see
what
her.
Did, we do?
Did you see her? If
yeah.
you seen Ellen's face when people made that standing ovation, it was unbelievable. Her face was like, oh.
So it
no.
was because she herself did not expect that.
She didn't expect it. She did not expect it. Well, I mean, people probably would have clued in that, oh, that's not the real Tina or whatever. Yeah,
but
no, I played along the whole time. And then everybody wanted to dance with me and Selena Gomez danced with me. And then Selena Gomez wouldn't leave me alone after that.
Did you get to tell her where you were dancing that you were
no, not? No, oh, I can't. Oh. I'm not allowed.
Your memory, your book of memories and achievements is just.
I have so many experience. I just would love to just dwell on the real good and positive and very, like, you know, uplifting experience. You know, I'm saying that, you know, there, you know, who doesn't have a hard time sometimes? If there will be like difficulties, there will be, you know, odds and, you know, but then, you know, against all odds, you know, it's always the positive and the best thing that you can do as a mother, an artist, and
that's true.
Everything.
That's true. What is a typical day for you?
Typical day is chaotic.
Wow.
Yeah, it's chaotic because a typical day, it's either multitasking or I'll be lucky to be able to sit down and just probably watch a little bit of news, and which sometimes I don't want to anymore.
Yeah.
Because it just gives me, like, you know, negativity, and I don't like that. Because once the negativity happens, when you see bad news, it just destroys my work. True. Because my work is to inspire people. And then once you are feeling down and sad, it's so hard to inspire people. So the typical day normally is constantly working, updating, and sometimes if I get lucky, have a little bit of time to cook. Oh. Yeah, because because we always are on tour.
Oh, yes. Oh,
and so we
gosh.
Always eat out.
You have to have a choice.
Yeah, because you don't have a choice, right? Yeah. So we always eat out. So whenever we're at home, and then we're staying home, and even if we're out doing chores, we still manage to come home and just have some healthy things that
Enjoy
we can put together.
That.
Yeah, it's hard. You know what? Yeah. We try to balance our mission and vision. It sometimes gets a little bit toxic if you are surrounded with all this negativity. Yeah. And the thing is, we learned now how to balance everything, that it's we cannot be there all the time for
True.
The people who have been abused or scammed or yeah. been bullied. We really wanted to, and we had so many calls, you wouldn't believe it. Not only around here, but all over Canada.
Oh my goodness.
And it's unbelievable the power of the internet.
Yes.
So you know, the online things, social media, it's so powerful that it, you know, people get to know you, and they think they know you so well that they trust you because of what you do and what
yeah,
you have been doing,
true.
and the
true.
respect, the trust, and is there. Not everybody we can help, because the thing is, they have to help themselves first.
True.
And they have to be seriously gonna be doing something about it before we even help
get
them.
Get involved.
Yeah. Or what we do, because sometimes, you know, Steve and I really wanted to help. We point them to the other
the right
people,
direction.
Like to get a lawyer,
yeah.
or to go to the cops, or to go to an immigration consultant, or to go to your local MLA. Yeah, right. Like here, oh, wow,
yes.
this is
go
so cool.
Go to your MLA. Right
go
away.
To your MLAs. Or there's always a platform for everything.
Yes.
And this is what I want to say to people in the community, and to any other communities that are experiencing. Things like this, like there's so many ways of doing it the right way.
True.
There's so many, just do it the right way.
Anything can happen in the community. It's just so good that you have so many things that are fruitful,
yeah.
that are exciting going on, because mm-hmm. you can just like, you know what, that's it for now. I have a Tina concert, right? I have my daughter. She's having lots of filming and auditions. I have my Kimi who's doing, you know, so many things to be thankful for. And I think that's why you continue to be positive and motivational, because you look at these things like you're grateful for what you have, right?
That's the number one thing, actually, is to feel grateful for everything.
Yes, yes.
Feel grateful for opportunities. Feel grateful for the supporters you have. Mm-hmm. Feel grateful that you have a family that loves you and support you, you know, or you have a community that really
believes in you.
That believes
yeah.
in you. And I just uplift,
True.
protect,
protect,
and inspire the right people in the community.
Thank you.
are just actually very busy here.
Yes.
Trying to work our selfie sticks. Where's my phone?
No, just my phone.
Because I told Louis here that we were going to talk about selfies.
Yes.
But first of all, while we're fixing our gadgets.
I know. Look at this.
Yours is really advanced, I think.
Yeah. Like,
I don't have voice power.
Let me see your selfie stick. Oh, that's good.
Are we the same?
We're the same.
Oh, my gosh, we're the same.
We're
sisters.
Do your kids, are they okay with you putting out your selfie stick, though, in the
public? No.
Okay, yeah.
They were like, Mom.
Oh, thank God. Mom.
Like, especially we're in a restaurant and then we're doing this. And then all of a sudden I have my selfie like, don't touch your food yet. And Steve was the first one who would be so annoyed with me because he was so hungry, but, you know, he would be like, stop. Do not touch.
You know, when I put this out, my girls would go, Mom, no. I'd be like, no, your Tita Louie uses a selfie stick. Look how lovely our photos are. So we are forever selfie
sticks are so good.
Yes, you can buy
it,
this.
And sometimes you don't need to hold it. So right. you just
like put it like there.
Yes.
There you go.
And then you can just walk around. And
so yes, if you're having second thoughts, please no.
Especially if there's nobody to take your pictures, right?
Yes.
Like, you know, so I can take the picture of the entire family, and then they're all happy every time it turns out good, right?
And everyone's there.
Yeah, otherwise, but then they didn't want me to take it out, you know, especially when we're in an event, Mom.
Yeah. So how is it being mom to Zenia and
Kimi? Kimi? I'm so proud and happy, and I don't know, you know how it is. I mean, you have two daughters too.
Yeah.
It's just super amazing. There are days when my life revolves around them, and it is just such a great feeling. It's a great feeling because no matter how old our daughters are, how old they get or whatever, you know, they're still your babies. Oh. So I call Kimi my big baby.
She's okay.
Big baby, and she's okay. And then Zenia is baby. Baby, baby Zenzia, the real baby, yeah. You know, and they act like babies, no matter how old they are.
Right.
And they still are. And it gets sometimes very cool because it's a humbling experience to be a mother.
Yes, that's true.
It's a very humbling experience. And then, you know, when you start to realize that it's not all about you anymore because these children or your girls or my girls are just starting to grow up, and then that's just like what we said a while ago when all of a sudden mommy's taking out selfie when, you know, during an event, and they were like, mom, and you know, they scold me.
They're the boss.
They are, and they tell me, mom, don't say that. Mom, don't do that. And it's like, it's so humbling because, you know, when they were growing up, I was the one, hey, don't do that. Hey, don't eat that. Hey, this. Yeah, but now it's them telling me it's the other way around, and which means that they got something from you. You raised them well, and they, you know. And sometimes we get to a point that because we're older, and sometimes, you know, I get away with like selfies, you know. Yeah. I take selfies and so it's just a matter of preference. Sometimes they allow it, sometimes they don't. But it's nice to know. It's nice to know how to feel that you have to give in sometimes,
yes.
and open your heart to your children's criticism and all the things that they would suggest. It's real good. It's so humbling. I just love it. What's more important is for your children to be happy and enjoying what they do. If you don't enjoy what you're doing anymore, stop it.
Stop it.
Or you can either stop it and do some other things, and then maybe you'll appreciate what you've been doing before, you know, and then you go back to it. I mean, give yourself a chance to grow and do something else. The world is so big, there are so many opportunities.
Never.
They're coming left and right. They're all coming.
Some of the opportunities are on stage. Just let them know, okay? Well, it was really good talking to you, Louis, because we even talked about motherhood, which is very, very important nowadays. Like, responsible parenthood is very important, given all the temptations going around, so many things going on. Like, children, it's very important to listen to your parents. And again, parents, it's also very important to listen
to listen to your children. That's right.
You don't always have to have the last say anymore. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, we may not be right all the time.
It's actually nice to have your children be opinionated on a lot of things, because you just want to make sure that they're also aware of what's going on in the world, not just all self-absorbed with whatever you're doing, like your songs. It's great. I mean, I always wish that the parents would always, like you, for example, you would encourage your children or even others to find a mission or an advocacy for their, even no matter who you are, whether you're a doctor, you're a nurse, you're a singer, performer, songwriter, you're a musician. As long as you have this goal in life to help others, I tell you, that's the best thing that you can ever do in your children's life.
True.
Yeah, just make sure that you do that. You encourage them.
Oh, Louis, that's wonderful. Thank you for sharing.
Oh, no, thank you for having me. This is so great.
Laughter.
Yes.
The selfie thing. And before I let you go, it's time for Quick Fire. We're doing Quick Fire with
Quick Fire.
Amazing Louis.
Oh, my gosh, what is it? Like, I'm so excited. Tribute artist, Lady Gaga.
Oh, yeah. What Tina Turner song makes you want to cry?
Oh, my God. Mostly, I don't sing it. Actually, I don't perform it. Yeah, no, it's really, whatever you want, whatever you do, I'll be right here waiting for you. That's one of the songs. It's not very popular here, but it's very popular in Europe.
What kind of fruit will you be?
Mango.
Woohoo, I love mangoes.
Do I look like a mango? Like, my face.
Describe yourself in three words.
I'm lovable.
Of course.
lovable.
And
inspiring.
Adorable.
Super adorable. I'm so full of myself.
This one, you will love it. If you were running for public office, what would your slogan be?
I'm simply the best. Better than all the rest.
Vote for me.
Yes. Woo.
Tina Turner.
Jesus Christ. No, that's not proud, Mary. No, it's not. There are so many. Oh my gosh, I'm so torn. What? 45 seconds? Well, what else? Simply the best.
Yes,
better than all the rest. Better than anyone. Anyone I ever met.
Oh my gosh, we got her to sing on the show, would you believe?
I'll send you the bill.
What would you do if you lost your selfie stick?
Oh my gosh, I'm gonna cry. I panic. But the thing is, if I lose this right now, I have 20 more in the house. But they're not as good as this, so I'm fine.
Three things you do before you go on stage, except for sound check, because it takes you 2 hours.
Three things I do. Yeah, well, three things I do. I sip. Water, like just sip, not drink, sip. Just sip water, but room temperature water. And then the second one is, I want to make sure that I'm wearing my Tina nose. Because sometimes I forget. Yeah, there's a Tina nose, so I have to really contour my nose, but sometimes I forget that.
Okay.
And then just make sure that it's all perfect. Like, and powder my face, like for mattifying it, yeah. And then the third one, make sure that I'm wearing my shoes, my Tina shoes, because that happened. I forgot.
Oh, really? What kind of shoes were you wearing?
My slippers.
Oh. There you go. So don't cry if you make some mistakes or you forget something, because someone as professional as hers, as her, did it. So there you go. It's normal. Normal to laugh, right? Today we learn to laugh at our mistakes and just be happy, right?
Just be happy, because mistakes are humbling.
Yes, and they make us grow.
That's right.
Which reminds me, purse. You carry a purse, right?
I carry luggage.
what three things in your luggage or purse do you carry until now?
Oh, right now?
Now that your kids are grown up, from the time they were little.
Even they were little and when they're grown up, the most important thing that I will always pack are baby wipes.
Baby wipes. There you go. See? An interview with Luisa Marshall is never going to end. Until then, have a great day.
Have a great day.
Bye.
Don't forget baby wipes.
Don't forget baby wipes and the very reliable self-esteem.
Wave like this and see that?
Ah. Wow,
one more. You don't need to talk.